Welcome to my series about cheat engine. Today I'll try to explain step 7 of the tutorial, coding action. This step, we have a button that decreases health by 1 when clicked, and your assignment is to change it so it increases by 2 instead. So first, we need to find the code that writes the value. You do that by finding the value itself and find out what writes it, which is the button code. So let's start, 87. 84, and here we go. Now we'll need to find out what writes it. And there we go. This is the code of the button. And in particular, this subtract instruction, which decreases the value pointed at by RSI plus 780 by 1. Now we can easily solve this tutorial by changing this to minus 2. And we have what we need. But since this tutorial goes about code injection, let's try that instead. First, we do autoassembler, code injection, and there you go. Here you see the basic code injection template. Alloc allocates memory for your code and calls it newmem. It allocates 2048 bytes, which is half a page, and allocates it near the address we hook tutorial plus 2D31B. This is very important in 64-bit targets because the distance between the original and the destination can be greater than 2 gigabytes there, which would result in a 14-byte long jump instruction instead of 5 now. So let's continue with the script. Here you see 3 label definitions. They tell Cheat Engine's assembler that these labels should be found in the script, and if they are not defined, give an error. It's not necessary to define them, but it helps with preventing bugs and a slight assembly speed improvement. After the labels, we see the newmem line. Because newmem is an alloc instead of a label, that means the write pointer gets set to the address of the allocated memory. At place your code here, you can write your own code, or you can write it anywhere you want, but this is the recommended location. Then comes the original code label assignment line. This tells Cheat Engine's assembler that at the address of original code is the current write pointer. Under that, we have the original code line. This can be multiple lines if the original code was less than 5 bytes. In this case, the original code is 7 bytes, so more than enough, even 2 more bytes, which we'll resolve by these 2 knobs later on. Now, following that is the exit label. After that, the jump to the label return here. Note that return here is still undefined, so that Cheat Engine's assembler will allocate 14 bytes for this jump instruction. Since we know the distance is less than 2 gigabytes, thanks to the third alloc parameter, we can tell it's a 5 byte jump by placing the text long between jump and return here. Then we get to the address we are going to write the injection at. This line will change the current write pointer to tutorial x86-64.exe plus 2D31B. There we'll have the jump to our allocated memory. So when the button is clicked and it's about to decrease the health value, the CPU will jump to our allocated memory instead and run our code in the new mem section. And eventually it'll reach the exit jump and go back to return here. Now, 2 knobs later, and return here finally gets assigned the current write pointer. And that's the basic layout of the code injection template. There are also more advanced templates, but I'll delve into them another time. So to solve step 7, we need to change the code's behavior so that the value increases by 2 when clicked. There are many different things we can do, like add 3 to the address. So we'll change it to an add instruction and increase it by 3. So 3 minus 1 ends up as plus 2. Or we can just jump over the original code and go directly to exit. Jump short exit because the distance is smaller than 128 bytes and changes to 2. Or I can just completely ignore and remove original code. And this jump can then also go. So let's just give this a try. Yes. All right. Click me. And as you can see, it now increases by 2 whenever clicked, and the next button has become enabled. I hope this has been educational, and I'll see you next time.